G'day. How hot is this beach? It's positive 30 degrees Celsius. How cold is this snowstorm? 10 degrees below zero. That's negative 10 degrees Celsius. This bird is 20 meters above sea level. That's positive 20 meters. The shark is 5 meters below sea level. That's negative 5 meters. These are examples of positive and negative numbers. Now let's see some examples with money. If I have $20, that's positive 20, I'm happy. But if I owe someone $20, that's negative 20, I'm sad. In this number line, positive numbers are on the right side, zero is in the middle, and the negative numbers are on the left side. Since positive numbers are greater than zero, and they're greater than negative numbers, the greater numbers are further to the right. Now let's compare some numbers, like positive 6 and positive 4. Which is greater? Well, positive 6 is further right, so it is greater. We can write positive 6 is greater than positive 4. But in maths we use symbols, so we write positive 6 is greater than positive 4, or we can write positive 4 is less than positive 6. Notice that the less than symbol looks like the capital letter L. Now let's compare 0 and negative 3. 0 is further right, so 0 is greater. We write 0 is greater than negative 3, or negative 3 is less than 0. What about negative 2 and negative 5? Well, negative 2 is further right, so it is greater. We say negative 2 is greater than negative 5, or negative 5 is less than negative 2. Let's put these numbers in ascending order. That is from smallest to greatest. First, put them in position on the number line. In ascending order from smallest to greatest, they are negative 6, negative 2, 0, 3, and 5. If we put them in descending order from greatest to smallest, they are 5, 3, 0, negative 2, and negative 6. How do we add and subtract with positive and negative numbers? Again, let's use money. Let's say I have $5 and a kind friend gives me $2. I now have $7. Let's do this on the number line. On the number line, we start at positive 5 and move two places to the right to get 7 as the answer. This means that addition on the number line is moving to the right. That means subtraction on the number line is moving to the left. Let's check with this example. I have $10, but I give away $4 to my friend. That's 10 minus 4, which is 6. On the number line, we start at positive 10 and subtract 4, so we move 4 places to the left to get 6 as the answer. Let's say I owe $4 and then I get paid in my job $12. What do I have then? That's negative 4 plus 12. On the number line, start at negative 4 and move to the right 12 places. The answer's 8. I now have $8. Let's say I owe $4 to one friend and I owe $5 to another friend. How much do I owe altogether? Start at negative 4 and go to the left 5 places. The answer is negative 9. Altogether, I owe $9. How do we multiply positive and negative numbers? Well, number lines take time to draw, so let's do this without a number line. Here's a helpful rule. It's called the SPUN rule, S-P-U-N. Letter S stands for same signs. Letter P stands for positive answer. The U stands for unlike signs or different signs. The N stands for negative answer. Okay, this is how the SPUN rule works. I'm given $2 from each of three kind friends. Altogether, that's $6. So positive 2 multiplied by positive 3 is positive 6. If the signs are the same, that is, they are both positive, then the answer is positive. What if I owe money? What if I owe $4 to each of three friends? That's negative 4 multiplied by positive 3, which is negative 12 because I owe $12 altogether. Using the SPUN rule, if the signs are unlike or different, that is, one sign is negative and the other is positive, then the answer is negative. Let's do some more multiplying examples. Positive 3 times negative 5. There are unlike signs, so the answer is negative. 3 times 5 is 15, so the final answer is negative 15. What about negative 3 times negative 4? Well, the signs are the same. They are both negative, so the answer is positive. 3 times 4 is 12, so the answer is positive 12. Negative 3 times negative 4 is positive 12. Now let's divide positive and negative numbers. We'll use the SPUN rule again. $20 is shared by 5 people. That's positive 20 divided by positive 5. The signs are the same, they're both positive, so the answer is positive. Then 20 divided by 5 is 4. The answer is that $20 divided by 5 people is that they get $4 each. Altogether, I owe $30 to my 3 friends. How much do I owe each friend? Well, that's negative 30 divided by positive 3. The signs are unlike or different, so the answer is negative. Then 30 divided by 3 is 10. The answer is negative 10. That means that I owe each friend $10. What's negative 15 divided by negative 5? Well, the signs are the same, so the answer is positive. Then 15 divided by 5 is 3. So negative 15 divided by negative 5 is positive 3.